Welcome back. In level one, we ended up talking about area charts and pie charts. Here is an area chart for the equipment, footwear, and apparel for purchases from 2009 through 2016. As we said before, this chart wouldn't be great if apparel values were greater than the footwear because they overlap here. We wouldn't see the footwear any longer since the green is in front of the red. There are several solutions to this problem. One of them is the stacked area chart. The difference between the plain area chart and the stacked area chart is that the data series are vertically stacked on top of each other as opposed to layered on top of each other like sheets of paper. For example, the equipment totals, or the first series, are displayed here on the bottom, followed by the footwear and apparel sales data values. What can be a bit confusing for folks lies in the fact that the data point values are stacked on top of each other in an additive manner. For example, for the year 2009, the equipment value is 18,971. We can see that by looking at the axis or just looking back over here at our underlying data. See the footwear is 12,816? On our stack chart, that value is shown over here in orange on the chart. We now see that the 12,816 is stacked on top of the previous 18,931, so the top of our orange range for 2009 is actually the sum of these two numbers over here in our table, or about 31,000. The apparel value of 11,127 is then piled on top of that sum to take us up to what looks like around 43,000. If we look over here at our data, we see that the sum of these product categories is 42,914, so that explains what we're seeing over here on the chart. This chart shows us the sum of all three categories for each year along the top of the top series and helps us visualize how much of that sum comes from each of the three different categories or series. This chart type is useful when you want to see the overall total across the top and also to see how much each individual series contributes to that total sum. Not only can you make stacked area charts, but you can also have stacked bar charts, stacked column charts shown here, as well as stacked line charts over here in this chart. You have to be very careful in using these stacked charts and be clear with your audience what you're displaying, as it would be pretty easy to misinterpret this chart here to think that the apparel sales are somewhere here in the 40s, the footwear sales are in the 30s, and the equipment sales are around 20,000. Could be confusing. Let's move on to another alternative that's a bit more commonplace and a bit less confusing. Here we have our regular area chart, and here we have our stacked area chart. Let's change the chart type by going up here and selecting another alternative, the dreaded 100% stacked area chart. This alternative shows the grand total now represented as 100%, and the three colors or product categories show as percentages of how much each category contributes towards that 100%. Note that the vertical axis is now a percentage scale as opposed to our purchase values shown in the previous chart types. So for the 2009 year, we have about 40% come from equipment. From 45 to 75 is the footwear, so that makes it about 30% of the total. And from 75 up to 100% is apparel, so that's around 25% of the 2009 overall total. Notice that this chart doesn't show us how much each yearly value was in dollars, just what each category's percentage contribution to the total was. This stacked area chart is generally less misleading than the plain old stacked area chart that we worked on a couple minutes ago. Note that we also have a 100% stacked bar chart, column chart, as well as the 100% stacked line chart. While I can maybe see this version of the column chart being used, I can only see our audience getting confused by the 100% stacked line chart, but we can do it nonetheless. Thanks, Microsoft. Again, all of these chart types are up here in the Change Chart Type menu on the Design tab. Note that there aren't any stacked or 100% stacked pie charts, since they already by default show each category's relative contribution to the entire pie. Moving on, here is some purchasing data for the years 2014 through 2016 for 22 different product categories. What we have done is created a pie chart for all of this data for all 3 years. Unfortunately, since there are 22 different categories, this is what the pie looks like. Let me move the legend over to the right of the chart. Still, a lot of the details and differences in the categories get lost, as you can see. Which category was the biggest? Which one was the smallest? Etc. One of the easiest things that we can do to fix this is to organize the categories in our underlying data. To organize this data, I'd like to sort it all by highlighting all of the data, then go up here and click on the Data tab. Here we now have the sorting tool. My goal is to sort all of the data by sales amount in a descending manner so that the biggest values are on top. In this first drop-down list, I pick the 2016 data column B, and then the values from largest to smallest, and then click OK. If we now look at our pie chart, we can see that the categories are listed from largest to smallest, and they start out at the 12 o'clock position of our pie. Or 12 o'clock position of our clock. I guess that might make a little more sense, but it's a pie chart, so 12 o'clock position of our pie. We can easily see that exercise is our biggest slice, so it has the most sales. The bottom of our legend here has the least amount of sales. In fact, you need to verify this since the legend only shows the number of categories that fit on the chart size, so as you resize the chart, the number of categories that appears in the legend changes. This can confuse our audience, so be careful when sizing your chart that you don't lose valuable information over in the legend. Looking at these last few or smallest pie slices, they get kind of jumbled up, and it's difficult to see what's going on in these small categories. This is where the different pie chart types come in useful. If we go up to our design ribbon and select our chart types, we see a few weird looking ones over here, and I'm going to pick the even more weirdly named one, the pie of pie. What this chart does is to take the last several smallest categories and break them out into their own separate pie, where the separate pie slices are now bigger and give you a bit more resolution, and you can see more easily what's going on with these smaller categories. The various parameters of our pie of pie can be adjusted by right-clicking on the pie itself and selecting Format Data Series here. Here you can adjust how many slices are in our second pie. By adjusting this value, we see the number of slices in our first pie gets moved over into our second pie. I can also see that we can explode our pie. Yikes! Change the width of our gap between the pies, and also adjust the size of our second pie. When we're done messing around with all of our pies, we can close this formatting bar. For pie charts, I'm generally not a big fan of legends, as they require mental effort to map this color here to this pie slice, so it's difficult to visualize that. I prefer instead to use data labels, so let's delete our legend completely by selecting it and then clicking the delete key. Now let's add our data labels. Right-click on the pie and select Add Data Labels, and then again, Add Data Labels. Now, if I right-click on any of the labels, notice that this selects all of the labels. I want to make sure they're all selected before I continue. If only one is selected, then all this work from here on out will apply only to the one label that I happen to have grabbed, so make sure they're all selected. Now format the data labels, and this pop-up comes up where we can customize exactly what we want to show in each of our labels. You can click through here and see what happens to our labels, but instead of the value, I want to choose the category name instead. We may need to adjust our chart size, maybe move it to another page, or adjust our pie gap to get it to tell the best possible story, and we can easily tell that these pie slices on the right display what's going on in this other pie slice over here in our original pie. That's it for this video. We'll see you in part 2.